Hey, hello, my name's Timothy, and I am a Good Foods Longevity distributor. And I love these products. I really love the results that I've seen people have gotten all over the world, you know, for me, all around the United States. And, you know, my sole purpose of being a distributor for these products is to help you. I love you. You need to know that. I love helping people. I love seeing people get results that they've been looking for forever, or for people who are just desiring to stay healthy and not understanding why they're not healthy. That's why I want to be your teacher. I will teach you. I will help you. I will guide you. You need to trust me. And I will trust you that you are really willing to go the distance. And with that said, I'm going to introduce you to Dr. Wallach. A brief description of Dr. Wallach. He's a wonderful person. He used to work with Marlon Perkins from back when they had The Wild Kingdom on TV. He was actually the veterinarian. So he learned through his practices, they actually cured over 900 diseases for animals. And by doing that, he understood that you can do the same thing for people. The only problem is the doctors don't want to cure people. They only want to give you drugs. When they cured polio and they cured smallpox back in the 50s, they stopped curing people. Now all they do is introduce drug therapy, and they refuse to help cure people, because you can give them a $30 lesson on how to be well and how to take mineral supplements or vitamins and how to eat right, or you can make $750,000 by giving them diabetic medications. And so the AMA is all about the money. Government's all about money, but we're not about that money. We're really about results that you deserve, and you need to know the truth. And so without further ado, I'm going to introduce Dr. Wallach and a few of the products along the way, and you decide whether or not you want me to help you. You decide whether or not living a life without any disease, that's capital D-I-S dash E-A-S-E, disease, is valuable to you.
So we've made a complete system, which we call the Mighty 90, and there's like 25 different ways to get that, depending on, you know, people have allergies to shellfish, or they've got allergies to this, that, and the other. So we've come up with 25 different ways to cover every known eventuality, whether they like liquids or capsules or whatever. We've covered all these things in what we call the Mighty 90. We assure them that they're going to get optimal, in many cases, 8,000 times or 16,000 times or 30,000 times the minimum data requirement. Because when you have a disease which is debilitating you to the point where doctors have got you on pharmaceuticals, they want to cut your knees out and put in artificial knees, people don't want to wait a year to be healed. And so what we've learned is to use a bigger hammer, and I call it, and to give them mega doses and nutrients to the point where we can rebuild joints, we can rebuild the cartilage. I've had people who's got their meniscus has been surgically removed because of terrible accidents. They've all torn up. Mm-hmm. They've surgically removed these, and we've rebuilt them because surgeons are sloppy. They always leave a couple of stem cells for me, and I can get to them and rebuild the cartilage, rebuild the meniscus. I do this all the time with these raw materials. And so we've learned over 33 years a lot. And so we use a heavy hammer so that within 3 to 6 weeks, people are saying, I can't believe this. I mean, I was on medication for 40 years. I'm off my medication now after 3 weeks. People who are all gnarled up with rheumatoid arthritis, it took a year, but their fingers are all straightened up and they can play the piano now. Okay? People who were scheduled, in fact, very famous people, Andrew Young, who was Jimmy Carter's ambassador to the UN. He was the mayor of Atlanta and the U.S. representative from the state of Georgia. He was scheduled for double knee surgery 20 years ago. And his son called me up and asked me to help him. And I regrew his knees 20 years ago. And he canceled his surgeries. He canceled his surgeries, and I rebuilt his knees for him. He's never had to rebuild his or have his surgery done on his knees. I'm the guy, through Andy Young, who rebuilt Evander Holyfield's heart. Now, you think about it. Here's a guy who had a heart attack during a championship fight, was able to go back and get a approval in the Boxing Commission physicals to go back to box professionally after he's had a heart attack. How can you do that? Well, I can do that. I take people off of the dialysis all the time. I get people off the heart transplant list all the time. I regrow cartilage. I grew a heart muscle. I grow knees. I regrow kidneys. I make kidneys function. Reverse muscular dystrophy in kids. I reverse cystic fibrosis in kids. And so it's very, very gratifying. Oh, here's another one. Dementias. Big problem now with 80 million baby boomers come along. They're all going to get dementia because they followed the doctor's advice. Alzheimer's disease is a physician-caused disease, just like vitamin D3 deficiency is a physician-caused disease. Erectile function and menopause are physician-caused diseases. I can tell by your face you're sort of like, what?
Yeah, menopause, I thought that was something that...
Well, menopause, our grandmothers went through menopause in 3 seconds without one hot flash. Now, our modern women spend half their life dealing with it, and they go through 3 husbands because guys can't stand it, right? And so basically what it is they've been told they got to give up cholesterol, right, in their diets. Well, cholesterol is the raw material for ovaries to make estrogen and progesterone. Cholesterol is the basic raw material to make steroids, which make estrogen and progesterone. So you go on a low cholesterol diet, you get cholesterol-lowering drugs, you're going to have menopausal symptoms to the point where you're like a flaming idiot, right? Men will have erectile dysfunction because testosterone is 95% by weight cholesterol. You want a cholesterol-restricted diet, cholesterol-lowering drugs, there's nobody home anymore, right? It's real simple. When it comes to Alzheimer's disease, 75% of your brain weight is this fatty insulation material called myelin. When you get Alzheimer's disease, the myelin goes away and the naked nerve fibers all tangled up, and it's legendary that nerve tangles are the iconic diagnostic feature of Alzheimer's disease. Nerve tangles compared to the other 3 classic dementias which don't have that. And this myelin, this fatty insulation material of the brain that makes up 75% of your brain weight, is 100% cholesterol. So you're on a cholesterol-restricted diet, take cholesterol-lowering drugs, there's nobody home up here, nobody home down there. I mean, life is a mess. Doctors for the last 50 years have been telling people to stay out of the sun because of skin cancer. Mm-hmm. Now, if you have to go out in the sun, Scott, be sure you're taking SPF 7 billion, you know, sun blocker to protect yourself. You have to wear long sleeves on top of that, gloves, big brim hats. Do not go out in the moonlight because you're going to get skin cancer. And for gosh sakes, do not take any vitamin A and D because it'll damage your liver. And so everybody in America has a vitamin D3 deficiency. Now they've discovered that vitamin D3 is useful. Oh, my gosh, everybody's got a vitamin D3 deficiency. Well, medical doctors cause that by telling everybody to get out of the sun and stay away from vitamin A and D. And so you think about it. All the diseases that doctors have caused now are found in the highest of levels in the baby boomers. Obesity is a physician-caused disease. 40% of Americans are obese. 40% of Americans are obese, Scott, and this is caused by medical doctors' misinformation, misadventure, and criminally negligent advice.